Hi, and welcome to my smart home channel. In today's episode, I will show you how you can make your dishwasher, washing machine, or dryer smart with Home Assistant. I will show you how to create a sensory Home Assistant which changes state and icon if the machine is empty, running, or done. To make any device smart, we need to get information based on different states of the device. So what information can you get from these devices? The information we can get from a dryer, for example, is the current consumption by using a smart plug with energy monitoring. To generalize a little bit, there are two different types of smart plugs with energy monitoring. There are the plugs which tolerate 16 ampere and 3500 watt. For example, the Schelle plug to the left here. And then there are the plugs which tolerates 10 ampere or 12 ampere and 2300 watt or 2500 watt. For example, the Schelle plug S to the right here. I use the Schelle plug and not the Schelle plug S just to be on the safe side, not to overload the plug. I use the integration Schelle Smart Home from Home Assistant Community Store to get the plug into Home Assistant. The other information we can get is if the hatch is open or not. For this, I use an Aquara door and window sensor with the Zigbee Home Automation integration. I have attached the sensor on the side of the hatch and the magnet on the hatch itself. But now, how can we combine and use this information in Home Assistant? The information from the current consumption and the hatch is used as triggers and conditions in order to trigger certain actions in Home Assistant and in the end update the dryer sensor. Let's start with the Schelle plug. If the current consumption goes to above zero, it means that the machine is on and the sensor is updated to state running. If the current consumption goes to below one and the door sensor is open, which means that the machine is not running, then nothing will happen. On the other hand, if the door sensor is closed, it means that the machine has been running and is now done. A toggle, a helper in Home Assistant, is set to indicate this, which in turn updates the sensor to done. Also, a push notification is sent to a phone to notify that the machine is done. If we look on the door sensor now, if the state changes to closed, nothing happens. This occurs when you're about to start a machine, for example. On the other hand, if the state changes to open, which happens when you're opening the hatch to take out the laundry, the toggle is set to state off, which in turn updates the state of the sensor to empty. I will now go through how to set this up for dryer and Home Assistant, but the logic is same for all the machines. Starting with showing how to create the toggle, the helper in Home Assistant, the sensor in configuration.yaml file, then the automation to set the toggle to state on and send a push notification, and lastly, the automation to set the toggle to state off. In Home Assistant, press Configuration and then Helpers. In the bottom right corner, press Add Helper. In the pop-up, select Toggle. In the new pop-up, enter the name Dryer and an icon if you like. I'm using the tumble dryer icon and then press Create. You have now created the helper, which will help to control the state of the dryer sensor. Note on the entity ID of the toggle, since we need it later on. We will create the sensor in configuration.yaml file. In Home Assistant, go to File Editor. Below the sensor integration, we will now add the sensor. We will use a template sensor and give it entity ID dryer, and then the friendly name dryer. To determine the state, we use a value template, and for the icon, an icon template. The logic for the both templates are the same. If the state of the toggle is on, the sensor will state done, and the icon tumble dryer alert. And here, add your entity ID of your toggle. If the state of the current consumption is above zero, the sensor will state running, and the icon tumble dryer. And here, add your entity ID of your current consumption for your dryer. Otherwise, meaning the toggle is in state off and there is no current consumption, the sensor will have state empty and the icon tumble dryer off. Don't forget to save and restart Home Assistant after adding the sensor. You can find the code in the description, so you don't need to type it yourself. In Home Assistant, go to Configuration and then Automations. In the bottom right corner, press Add Automation. In the pop-up, select Start with Empty Automation. Name the automation Dryer Done, and for trigger, select trigger type numeric state, and for entity, select the sensor for the current consumption of the dryer, and for trigger, when the state goes below 1. For condition, select the condition type device and the device door sensor of the dryer, and the condition when the door is closed. For the first action, select action type call service to call service input boolean turn on. As for target, use the pick entity function to select the toggle you created earlier. For the second action, select action type call service to call the service to notify mobile app, your phone. And for message, select dryer done or something similar. Name the automation dryer empty. For trigger, select trigger type device and select the door sensor as the device for trigger when the door is opened. For action, select action type call service to call service input boolean turn off. As for target, use the pick entity function to select the toggle you created earlier. Now, let's summarize what we have done. We created a sensor with the default state empty when the current consumption is 0 and the door sensor is open and the toggle is off. When the current consumption changes to above 0 and the door sensor is closed and the toggle has state off, the sensor changes state to running. When the current consumption goes below 1 and the door sensor is closed and the toggle has state on, the state of the sensor changes to done. I'm using the Lovelace custom button card to change color of my sensor. If you want me to do a video on how to use the custom button card, please drop a comment in the comment section. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button with notification on. Have a great day.